Hello. I'm going to share with you a behind the scenes look at an exciting project I just finished a couple of weeks ago. I had a 17 piece band performing at a wedding in two different rooms at the same time. And so we're going to talk about how I was able to do that. My Behringer X32 and Ableton Live were instrumental in making that possible. As well as some products made by Behringer. It was really, really cool. I think you're gonna like it. I'll take you through the whole process. First, we'll have a look at the venue, and then I'll take you behind the scenes of my evolution of the plan for the gig. Then we'll look at my Behringer mixer setup, then I'll take you through Ableton Live. And then finally, we'll get to the music itself. Okay, so hope you enjoy it. Peace. Hey, this is Ryan and Andrew.
Hey.
From Design Sound. And Andrew's gonna be doing our monitors, and Ryan is the boss. He runs it over there. And they are fantastic. We met doing Stevie Wonder's wedding, where Ryan and I did, but Andrew and I have long history together. But I'm here really to talk about what's going on with this room and the transformation that we all are doing. Ryan, you want to talk about the setup, and why don't you give them some insight into what we're doing?
So what the cool thing about this room, it's a shell. And then normally the room is like dark colors, and then you walk in here, it's gleaming white. We're transforming that with the core, and you can see the lights are coming together. Behind us on stage, we're bringing in these new speakers from L-Acoustics, which is very exciting for us. These are called Sivas.
Wow, they're pretty.
So far, we're the only company in Southern California has these guys, so we're excited. This is the first time to be used in this room.
All of it?
So we're super excited.
Andrew?
It's based on the same rig that you would use in an arena.
Uh-huh.
Just reconfigured it to be four rooms of this size.
Uh-huh.
Really amazing.
Oh, nice.
A lot of sound on these little speakers.
Are they powered?
Nope.
They have amps and stuff.
All the gear is going to be in the behind.
Uh-huh.
Keep it nice and clean.
Uh-huh.
And then we've got Andrew going to be over here, side stage and monitor.
Uh-huh.
In the back.
Nice.
Rob Davis way in the back.
Uh-huh, that's his console.
And it'll be neat to see this room. We have
I can't wait.
And guests.
Yeah, tomorrow you'll get to see on the before this video is over, you'll see what happens to it. And this is all of our gear that has come in.
It's all pre-production.
Pre-production.
The before and the after.
Yeah, you're going to enjoy the after, guys. I'm telling you. We got some real nice tricks in store. And we're doing something tomorrow that I've never done in my many years as a musician, and that's play in separate rooms. I almost did it I felt like on Idol, on American Idol. They had Ricky and half the band, and I was way on the other side of the stage. I used to have a talkback mic just to even speak to Ricky. So I'm used to being isolated, but there we tried to compensate in different ways, but it's different. You know, like I had a huge wedge just to try to get a sub over there to try to make it feel like.
Oh, yeah, because Teddy was on the other side.
Teddy, and I was standing next to percussion, so there's no meat coming, no body, not a bass. And then Paul was in front of me on guitar, and he plays in ears.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like I'm on the outside wing. Yeah. You know, all the way on the edge. So, you know, tomorrow I'll be playing outside on the other side of those doors. And so will four string players, five singers, and the guitarist, while the rest of the band lives here. So we're going to see how that works out. I'm excited about that.
It's going to be an adventure.
Okay, and here we are the next day. My rig is all set up. You see my Motif, my Nord Stage 2, Avion, my Push, my Roland sampling drum pad, I think it's the SPD-30, my iPad controlling my X32 rack. You notice the lights on the Push when I put them in order. I'll talk about that later. My Ableton file, which I'll also go into more detail on. This is my rack. I switched my Behringer active DIs for the Radial Pro D8 passive DIs, and I like that. Someone brought that up on my American Idol YouTube, American Idol tour. That's my S16 in that two space rack there. That gives me the extra outputs, which are the Pro Tools outputs. My pedal board setup, vocoders on the left, and there's also a box that mutes the talkback mic for the in-ears so they don't have to listen to it all day. The vocoder is powered via the Nord Stage 2. There's one patch that has an output that sends just to the vocoder for that time when I want to use it. This is the little thing I came up with for the string players to make sure that they had a nice sound source, time source. They can tap the tempo and start and stop it with the sustain pedal because they're playing by themselves for the prelude. So when I first thought about doing this gig, I knew I needed a band in the ballroom for the reception. I needed a band in the garden for the wedding. So initially I thought, okay, well, I'll have two drum sets and I'll do the wedding with maybe just the drums, guitar, bass, and keyboards. No horns. They wouldn't play on those songs. And the strings in the garden. Basically, two separate setups was the initial plan. And from a sound perspective, I figured that we would take a split off of the main console in the ballroom and set up a second system in the garden that would be totally independent. But all of that really grew into something else. I was able to use my S16s and the SD16, which are stage boxes made by Behringer, to really expand my rig. And once I came up with that, then I was just like too excited because that allowed me to really do some things that I hadn't done before. My keyboards in the garden were plugged into my mixer on stage in the ballroom via the Cat 5 cable, which you can have, I understand, up to 100 feet. And so that was really cool. So my speakers were plugged into this SD16 box. I also had a metronome for the string players because I wanted them to be tight when they played for the prelude. So I gave them their own metronome, which went into my mixer, which went down the bus that I created for the leads, or for the talkback bus, the click talkback bus. I used Ableton Live, which is my program of choice for live performances. I use Pro Tools, but not in situations like this. Anyway, so I'm gonna take you through my Ableton file so you can see exactly how I do it. My approach is a little different than I was taught initially. I'll take you through that. Anyway, you're gonna like it, I think. I was just really excited. So anyway, the idea came to me, well, you know what? Why don't I use the whole band? And I just put everybody on clicks. And so we can play together from different rooms. And people were like, oh, that's kind of risky. I don't know if that's going to work. I said, I think it'll work, so let's go for it. So that's what I did. Fortunately, I also have P16s, which are the headphone boxes that Behringer makes to go with the X32 system. So you can, everybody can be on click. I have 8 of those. And so I think, you know, having my own in-ear system made this whole thing possible because we didn't really switch to AVIOMs until the last 2 days. But, you know, of course, we had to rehearse with Click to be able to do all of this stuff. So it worked itself out. Also, initially, I thought that I would use my P16s with their monitor console, and it was just getting to be really, really too complex. And so I thank Randy Faustino, who's my good friend, who mixes Idol and The Four and a lot of the shows that I've done. He recommended to me that we not try to do the P16s in conjunction with their monitor console and my Behringer and all of that. It was just too much. So anyway, we used their AVIOMs and it just really streamlined everything. So anyway, I'll take you through my Ableton, my mixer file, and then I'll take you through my Ableton file. All right. okay, this is my mixer setup for my X32 rack, which is actually on stage with me. As you can see, I have the SBD, my drum pad is here, channels 1 and 2, my motif, my stage. Then I have a talkback on my rig, which is sent to a bus. That's what that is. And now these are my garden instruments, my RG700, my garden talkback, and the strings, the metronome for the string players. Now here are my Pro Tools playback tracks. I used a SD16 to take 8 outs of this into the house system, which is something also I had never done. A lot of times I'll use my 828, my Motu 828 is playback, and I have 8 channels of that as well. And actually 9, because I send the click out separate there as well. Okay, this is how I run my buses. I use bus 1 and 2 to go to the house. 3 and 4 are my stage speakers, and bus 5 and 6 are my garden speakers. Okay, and pretty much that's my setup. That's my setup for the garden and for the ballroom on my X32. Okay, now let's go to my Ableton setup. This is my master file for the wedding. And I first started using Ableton 2010 when I did a concert for my Song Without Words CD. I wanted to have the flexibility of having the band follow me. And so I'd heard about live. So anyway, I didn't have a lot of time to get ready. So what I did was I hired someone. And the way they told me to set it up basically was put all of the files in a column like this for the different songs. And then make my adjustments here with the level here. And so I did it that way for the first time, but now that I know live a lot better, I choose not to do that, with the exception of my click tracks. I put them all together. I use groups. So I have a click track here. This is my accent track. Sometimes I'll have separate clicks. Let's see if we're on or not. Access in a separate track, so I can just turn it up and down until it feels good. 1, 2. Then I have my slate on a separate track. 4. Okay. So this is the file for love. And what I do is I put them all in individual tracks. That way, I can just mix it here. As you can see, I have them on separate outs. These are the keyboard strings that I use that I turned off. I pre-recorded my strings so I'd have a good balance on them. So anyway, the whole thing, backgrounds included. Groups before I let go. Perception Medley. This is just the two trap we played on top of. But as you can see, there's click for everything. Clicks are here. Yeah. So that's pretty much how I did the whole show. It's time to get to the music. Enjoy.
You ready? Trigger.
I'm afraid I don't know how. 'Cause there's a possibility that you'd look at me differently, love. Ever since the first moment I spoke your name, from then on I knew that by you being in my life, things were destined to change, love. People use your name in vain. Love. Those who have faith in you sometimes go astray. Love. Through all the ups and downs, yours hurts. Love. first. Oh, 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 oh. Many days I've longed for you, wanting you, longing for the chance to get to know you, longing for your kiss, for your touch, your feel, your essence, yeah. Many nights I've cried from the things you do, felt like I could die from the thought of losing you. I know that you're real, with no doubts and no fears and no questions. To me, no, but now I know you're all I need. Oh, the world looks so brand new to me. Now that I'm a lover, every day I live for you, yeah. And everything that I do it for you. Oh, what I say is how I feel. So believe it's true. And make this love feel relevant. Didn't you know I loved you from the start? Yeah, I think about all the years we put in this relationship. Who knew we'd make it this far? I think about where would I be if we were to just fall apart. And I can't stand the thought of losing you.
We ain't getting no younger,
girl, no.
Let's get married.
frankly, girl, I'm tired of this emptiness. I wanna come home to you and only you. Cause making love to just anyone ain't happening. I just gotta be with you. If you think about us finishing something we started so long ago. I wanna give you my all. When I think about maybe us having some babies. Come on, won't you be my lady? Whoever, girl.
Strings. I don't want to see her before those high strings hit. Let her be patient. Stand up, have the people stand up. Ready? Fanfare trigger. me a little drum roll for a time with that. For a time. Let me hear a drum roll, drum roll. Somebody let me know when she's there. I can't see.
She's there.
You ready? Trigger, best part.
Wait a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs.
This
you care? You've given me the thrill of a lifetime. And maybe, believe, you've got more thrill to spare. Oh, this will be an everlasting love. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You brought a lot of sunshine into my life. You filled me with happiness. I never you and me, yes, sirree, eternally. Hugging and squeezing and kissing and pleasing together forever, three or whatever. Yeah, 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 yeah. You and me, so long as I'm living true love, I'll be giving to you, I'll be serving, cause you're so deserving. Hey, you're so deserving. You're so deserving, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, love, love, love.
What?